I think I am live, and I don't know if you can hear me. If so, please let me know if you can hear me because I am on my phone. My internet died. So can you hear me, Terry?
Now on YouTube.
Can you hear me now? Okay, and we are live, and I am sorry. I have one camera, and that's my phone. And I am having a Monday on a Wednesday. So let's see. I can see some of the chat. I can see, let's see, Terry and Gail and Sandy, Joanne, Michelle, Sue. I'm sorry, people. We were having weird things with our internet last night. And evidently the wind is really windy right now. And it just sort of took out my internet. And I did not have a backup plan for being able to show two cameras. One of these days, maybe I will have the iPad set up for that too. So we can sit here and chat face to face for a little bit if you want. Or I don't know. Terry, hi.
I'm on YouTube. I have got a real lag.
I'm sure it's because I'm coming from the phone, which is my phone Wi-Fi rather than the actual connected Wi-Fi. I think, yeah,
so
we're going to have some.
Why don't I disappear so people don't get confused? Mm. I'll shut off my camera.
Okay.
And I'll just listen to you. And there we go.
And we'll see how it goes. Yeah, let's see if I can, if I go this way, at least it's a better YouTube thing. I know. Isn't Terry's braided hair gorgeous? I'm going to see if I move this up any. There we go. That's a little bit better. So we're not quite so close up. I can, I don't know. I can't flip you down to show you what I'm working on. So people,
don't worry. We'll want to see your face. Just talk away. Talk away.
So, Sandy says, the YouTube was uploading her video upside down. That's no fun. I will, let's see, before I start doing it, let me hold this up. My brain is just over full, people. It is over full. But here is what I'm working on today. And honestly, all I was going to do is sew on some of these little, I forget where the camera is on the phone, little bits of organza ribbon. And then I've got some big beads. Mm-hmm. And so I am going to be doing that for a little bit. Gosh, every time you think technology is figured out, but I should have known. My husband isn't home. He's out running errands, but there's nothing he could do. Our internet comes because we have a direct line of sight to the satellite dish or whatever it is that the internet company uses, and we're the only one on it. So it's like until we complain, they don't know there's something wrong. So I have to wait for him to get home to fix that. And I'm rambling. But, you know, it's one of those days. I guess that means I can record a video later today for tomorrow. Thank you, by the way, all of you people that have been sharing my videos or my channel or things, because I have been experiencing some amazing growth. And I'm so grateful to all of you. I'm feeling a little discombobulated because right now there's been a lot of people coming over looking at the old where to find free images videos, which yes! I'm glad I did, but you know, they're ancient and a lot of stuff has changed. And of course, you know, they were early videos, so I wasn't as good at doing videos. I think I'm much better at doing them now. At least I hope so. But I'm grateful. There's interest out there still. There is a lot of interest, and you know, it's frustrating because what they'll tell you if you're doing YouTube and you're trying to really do a YouTube as your business sort of thing. I have these long tails. I've got to cut off of these guys. They'll tell you that if I want to be a stitching channel or a sewing channel of some kind or whatever, that I should unlist all of those old videos that are about finding free images, because right now people are coming thinking, oh wow, one of these days she's going to do another one of those and I'm going to get it. I'm not going to do another one. I thought about it, but then it just sends the wrong message to the algorithm. So I'll leave them up, but I'm not going to do any more because there are so many people doing those kind of videos. And yeah, a lot of them are crappy voiceover from AI kind of stuff, but it's just not, you know, I don't have the time to do that and still do these things that I want to do. And I really, I'm super focused on finishing the wildscapes. That's just where my energy is right now, is I want to get them done and get them launched and, you know, see where they take me.
Well, personally speaking, I find that those videos helped me a lot, and they'll head people in the right direction. That's all.
Yeah. And, you know, I might do a video now that's going to do this. I could do a video that says, hey, here are some other people that are doing these sorts of things. But honestly, I do like to send the right message to YouTube. So it was really exciting for me when the last video where I was showing how to do the detached bullion stitch got a lot of views, because it's like, yes, that's the thing that I'm trying to get YouTube to recognize. Hey, you know, if you like Roxy's Journal of Stitchery, if you like Ariane Zuscher, you might like Susan Taylor Brown. That's my goal. So anyway, that's I'm going to be 900 miles an hour because I was not expecting to have to think on my feet like this about the internet. Oh, well. So what's everybody working on? Tell me, Terry. Terry, what have you doing lately? What's happening?
I am working on a signature that is for a beach-themed journal. It's for a signature swap for the retreat I'm going to. Do you mind if I mention
the name? No, we do. We always like to support one another.
It's Damsels in Lace Soiree. And it's going to be in Carlsbad, California. It's the first week of June. And it's by Georgette Miller, I think. And Sheila Gingrich are getting together, and a couple other talented ladies. And they're going to be hosting it for 5 days. And the last day, they're going to have a tour of wine country.
Ooh.
I'm not going to be going. I'm going to be heading home that day. But it's supposed to be a lot of fun. The last year, the people who did the Stowe retreat had a wonderful time. So that's what I'm working on. And I'm hoping to maybe have a little bit more of it done so that I can bring it with me when we have our chat on Thursday.
Oh, tomorrow. Nice. Tomorrow, yes. I do not have the link handy because, again, no internet, but maybe Terry can grab that tomorrow. It must be the afternoon Zoom because I have a morning meeting. So it is our afternoon Zoom. If you haven't signed up and you want to, we would love to have you join us. I think I need to make more of this organza stuff. These are just little gathers of organza, and I just love the look they add this thing.
Ooh, yes. I'm looking at a post from Philippa. Kitty cat stuffies with pieces and lots of crocheted flowers and embroidery. And
there's been some great stuff happening in the group, and I appreciate you guys keeping that thing. You know, you guys really took a huge weight off my shoulder when a lot of you said it was more like a bulletin board where you could share your pictures, you could see what was happening in my world, and that sort of like freed me up, and I didn't feel nearly the pressure. I will say, I'll give a call out for the newsletter again, because the wildscapes will be available first to people that are on the newsletter. For the first 24 hours, they will get first dibs on that. So but Zoom is tomorrow. I have not scheduled a conversations for this month because a whole bunch of meetings happened. God, things just wacky. I thought February is going to be my crazy month, and it seems like March is crazier. All right, what have I got here? This is not something to use. I think I'm just going to put some big beads on here, and then I'm going to do some drizzles, I think.
I'm not getting what I'm looking for, so
I'll go to my website and go to the Creative Circle page. There's a link at the very top of the page, and on there is the link. It's just the Creative Circle. Let's see, SusanTaylorBrown.com/Zoom, I think. I don't know how to do it on my phone while without, I'd probably drop the phone knowing me. Well, at least you can't see my woggling all over the place because I forgot to put this thing in the stand. You know, do things ever calm down, maybe? I mean, I keep taking things off my plate, and yet I'm still going crazy. Michelle, oh, you got your, did you get your felting materials? Is that what that was about, Michelle? I remember you saying that you were ordering some stuff. I find the needle felting really fun. One of the other reasons I want to get the wildscapes done is now I have experiments I want to do on different things that I can add to them. And I need to get this batch done because I don't want to stay. If I start experimenting now, I'll never let myself finish. And I want to be a finisher. I'd like to be a finisher. It would be so nice. Did I do? I'm trying to get a button on here and somehow I managed to go through the holes in a weird way. Okay, where we go. So basically, if you want to sign up for Zoom, just go to SusanTaylorBrown.com, click on the link at the top of the page that says Creative Circle, and there's a link there to get to the Zooms.
There we go.
Did you find it? Oh, thank you.
Yeah, I found it. I was cutting and pasting while you were talking.
Ah, thank you. Yes, and thank you, Gail, for letting people know. My internet died, so I am on my phone, and I can only do the one camera with the phone. So that's what's up with that.
Oh.
What? Hey, Margaret.
A felted landscape, and Gail wants to do one, too. And Mouse just went for a walk with the dog. And Philippa went down a rabbit hole yesterday with QuiltCon videos.
Oh,
it's dangerous even knowing there's even such a thing.
Yeah. But it's also, I was thinking about this last night as I, oops, that one looks like it's got blue on it. That is not a good pearl. Blue pearls are nice. They just don't belong on this white piece.
Oh, no, they belong on a blue piece.
They do, or they belong in a multicolored piece. Let's see this little white one on. Yeah, I meant to go grit more. This is a good piece to use up the really big pearls that often are just too big. But since this is a larger piece that I still don't know how I'm going to finish, it's about... I think it's going to be about 10 by 10. So it could go on a canvas. It could be gathered into a shape, which is sort of where I'm sort of leaning. I don't know. I don't feel like I have found my definite favorite way of finishing something.
Those little velvet puffballs are cute.
Aren't those neat? I love these. This is, that's one of the things I want to experiment with is I love them like this, but I want to do some with some very fine threads coming out, some French knots coming out, but I need to give myself some time to experiment with the ways I want to do it. And I want to do some variations on the drizzles and the cast on stitch as well. Oh, Margaret, sorry, I'm sorry you're having a rough day. Jinx, you owe me a Coke, right? Isn't that what we used to say?
I have no idea. I know it's a jinx, but I don't know what the
it's
rest
that,
is.
Come on, Barbie, wasn't that what it was, Sandy? Jinx, you owe me a Coke? That's what I seem to remember. Of course, knowing me, I put like two or three different memories together. You're allowing yourself to take a break? That's good.
I just remember my brothers doing punch buggy. It hurt.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, there was that. That wasn't good. I didn't like that. My cousin Mike would do that all the time.
It's obnoxious.
It is. Yeah. Okay. Let's see here.
Barbie says, so let's stay on all day.
Nice long break. My husband is out running errands and called and asked me if I wanted something while he was out. And I'm like, I would not complain about a hot chocolate. Now I'm really glad I asked him for that. Cause it's like, I feel like when anything goes not according to plan, it's like, yes, I need a reward for being able to stick with it. Jinx, you owe me a coat. Okay. So you remember the same thing. Sandy's giving Margaret hugs. I can read the, if I go really close and then you get that close up of my rosacea face. Oh, well.
We love your face.
Thank you. I'm just going to breathe.
You can paint it green or purple or whatever you want. We still love it.
Thank you. I was thinking, okay, I'm wearing purple today. I was thinking about colors because I was trying to, you know, plan out some future videos. I have a really neat green video that I want to do. And I wish I knew, I don't know when I fell in love with green, but if I go back in time, I can see how, gosh, even back to my first marriage, which was, you know, 50 some odd years ago, my bridesmaid dresses in there were green. But as a kid, I think it was purple. I think purple was my thing. I had a purple full fur bedspread. And that was, God, I love that thing. I took it with me for ages. Fake fur, of course, because, you know, real fur. Mm-hmm. Unless it was a Barney bedspread.
Cookie Monster.
No, isn't Cookie Monster blue? He's blue.
Cookie Monster can be purple if he wanted to be.
That's true. If he's a Cookie Monster, he can be whatever color he wants to be. You're right. You're right. I have been doing so many drizzles on the little wildscapes, which has got me thinking about I want to play with some variations on it. So I'm excited to do that. On Sunday, we're going over to my in-laws for St. Patrick's Day dinner because they're Irish. And so I've been thinking, what am I going to take with me to do? And I think I'm going to take some yarn and a hoop and do some experimental stitches because I don't want to do anything. I don't want to take any of my nice stuff over there because two dogs, big dogs, crazy dog, that stuff.
Yes, Gail, Margaret is not having a good day today.
It's nice to come into other places where there's some positive energy that you can pick
absolutely
up. And I know it is early since we had the time change. I know those of you in Australia, Margaret and Philippa, you guys have got super early hours to join us. And I appreciate that. I was actually thinking the other day, I was thinking, do I need to try and adjust Zoom days and Zoom times of days and lives and Montgomery Ward. Oh my goodness. I bought my junior prom dress at Montgomery Ward too. And you know what color it was? Green. Green flowers. I just remembered that. With a very, very high neck and lots of ruffles. Wouldn't even fit one bar. Yeah. I can't look back at old clothes like that.
I saw someone today when I was out and about wearing overalls, and it made me think of the overall dress that I want to make.
I can't wait to see that overall dress.
I'm excited.
Although you're going to come home from your retreat all excited about journal making and ephemera and stuff. So,
Oh my God.
Yeah, when you're around, I can remember when I would go to writers conferences. I mean, you want to do all the things. And I was talking with another friend on the phone the other day, another artist, you know, and saying how I get to this point, like the wildscapes. Okay, there's 21 wildscapes that will be in the first collection, that this first of 2024 collection that get launched. I'm super excited, but they are all at the point where they need to be off the hoop and start getting framed up. And I get there to that point and I'm like, okay, I'm ready to go do something else now. And I was talking with my friend. I'm like, oh, you know, I could go do this thing with the dogs and I could go back to the book. And she's like, no, you just need to finish the darn wildscapes. I don't know why. What is it when we get close to the finish line? We want to start something new. Or is that just me, right? Is that just a Susan thing?
I think it might be a little bit of a panic. 'Cause you really have when you're doing the finishing touches, you put so much emphasis on it being just perfect that I think it, I think that you try to avoid that stress.
I think the avoidance makes sense, but I've decided it's not perfect. And here's what I've decided. It's not perfect that I'm going for. I want to tell the truth. Each of my pieces of art is a story. And, you know, as you guys know, you know, before I devoted myself to art, I was a writer for 25 years and I wrote a lot of books. I wrote books for work for hire, which means they gave me a topic. They gave me a word link. They gave me a sentence link in some cases. You know, I had to write certain things to their standards. Same thing when I was working with the newspaper. There was no heart in that. It was more information gathering and sharing. My drizzle does not want to come out of the needle. And then when I worked for an educational publisher, you know, you had certain things. You know, if I was writing about the Civil War, you know, I had to do the research. My heart wasn't there. I enjoyed the story, but my heart wasn't there. There are, I think there are three books that I can say that I have written that my heart is absolutely there on the page. And it's the same way with art, that there's some art where I feel like I was doing it to kind of figure out where I was going to go next. And there's nothing wrong with that. And a lot of it is good art and a lot of it was mass making, but it wasn't the art from my heart. And it was because I didn't understand then that I was trying to tell a story. And I don't mean, you know, you look at it and you can say, well, she started here and she went there. But a story, when you read a really, really good book, whether it's a picture book you're reading to a grandchild or a novel that you're escaping into, the same thing when you watch a movie or a TV show that you connect with, it's that connection. It's the thing that I talk about our creative circle. It's that connection. And in art, somebody is going to buy my art or your art because they feel that connection. And that connection happens when you're telling the truth of the story in your art. If you're making it because you saw somebody else make something like it and they sold it for a lot of money and you think, wow, you know, that's what I need to do. If I want to make some money, I need to make one of those things that somebody sold for a lot of money. You're not going to have truth in your story. You're not going to have the right story in your art that is going to connect with as many people as it would if you put your heart into it. And, you know, I mean, I've said that a lot over the years. You know, you make art because it's making you happy, because that's what shows up in your work. Wow. Who got my soapbox out?
I don't know, but Margaret said that she thinks it's not just you that gets to the end and starts getting afraid, that your fear of wrecking it at the last minute.
Boy, there is that too. There's absolutely that too, that you worry that something is not going to come together the way it's been in your head. And honestly, things rarely come together the way I have them in my head. Usually they come together in such a way that they surprise me. And I'm like, whoa, I did not expect that to take that turn. But before you get to that point, and you have to become a very brave creative to reach that point, but before you get to that point, you are thinking, I'm going to mess it up. You know, it's a lot of hours. When you're doing something like this, it's a lot of hours. And it's not like a painting where you can slap a layer of gesso over it and start over. I can, you know, cut some things off and I can layer over them, but it's much more time intense than, you know, tackling it with some gesso or something. My husband just came home. Let me let him know that the internet went wonky and is out and I'm online with my phone. It may be back on again, but I can't check right now. Hey, Wendy and everybody else that logged on. I can't read. I can't go back very easily to see who popped in, but thank you for joining us today in this odd live stream.
Well, we've had quite a bit of conversation about prom dresses and such. Michelle made her own.
Oh, wow. Good for you.
Prom dress she made. And it was a shiny backless powder blue one.
Oh, and powder blue was popular when we were in high school, Michelle. Yes, we're the same
absolutely.
Age.
And then you wore a powder blue eyeshadow, too.
Absolutely. And or if you were really daring, the blue mascara. I loved blue mascara. Oh.
And then Barbie says that she went with a date that was not her actual boyfriend because she was secretly dating someone else that her mother forbid her to go with.
Oh, no.
Yep. Barbie was trouble even back then.
My senior prom dress was blue. My junior prom was green. My senior prom dress was blue. And the lady that used to make all my skating outfits made it for me. And my mother was less happy because she made it, you know, the skating outfits had to be rather form-fitting because you were skating. And, you know, my mom didn't like me having quite the form-fitting dress, but I loved it.
Aww.
In fact, I just recently found one. It had little heart buttons down the, it had a sweetheart neckline that had little heart buttons there. And I just found one of the buttons from that. Gosh, that was back from 1976. Wow.
My junior prom, I had a cream dress with little bouquets all over it, teeny tiny ones. And they were of dark green, purple with a touch of orange on the junior prom. And on my senior prom, I borrowed a lovely dress. It was aqua with an overlay of sheer that had all these gorgeous, beautiful spring color bouquets on it. And it had a sheer cape that came down to my shoulders and went up to a choker style. So it was from the neck to my shoulders, a beautiful sheer capelet. And the most wonderful thing I remember about my junior prom was that my corsage was made of sterling roses, and they are the most wonderful, heavenly smelling roses ever.
Wow.
My favorite.
Mouse said something about how getting to the end, she's worried, she knows roughly how everything will go, so the fun of the challenge disappears. I get that way about midway. I realized that last night as I had, because I'm doing some small wildscapes. Thank you, Barbie, for that suggestion. And I had like four on one of the large hoops, and I had that like three or four different times. And I realized by the time, you know, I had the little puff balls and I had some French knots, and I'm like, they're boring. These are boring. I don't like them. There's no challenge in them. But then I started going vertical. And as soon as I started coming up off the fabric and going vertical, I got excited all over again. So I think for me, I made 21. Okay, there's a lot of reasons why I made 21. Number one, I am going to take them down and have them photographed. And I figured if I'm going to spend the time with a photographer and, you know, spend a chunk of money, which is going up, you know, now that I'm going to have more pieces to photograph, that I should, you know, should get a nice selection, because now I want to then be able to start submitting them to not just some calls for art, but I've got an article I've written that I would like to submit to a magazine. And so I think there's too many, but it's been helpful because working on the small ones has told me I don't have enough room to talk about the things I want to talk about in the story. Like if I'm working on a very small 4-inch hoop, I can't really get much water in there the way I want to do it. And I can't get a big pile of rocks and I can't do the hills. So it's good for me to have done them and figure out ways to tell an interesting story. And then to acknowledge that, you know, I want to work on something bigger. So my two cents. I'll be quiet for a minute and let Terry get us caught up on chat. I can't read anything. It's just too hard. Or you'll be looking at my nose if I get that close to the screen.
Well, we have, if you don't mind, a little bit more prom news.
Yeah.
Gail made her dress. And it was burgundy velvet.
Yeah. Wow.
And it was in 1971. And let me see. Barbie said she wasn't a trouble student. She was the student council president and a serious athlete. It's just that her parents were very, very strict, and she didn't get to communicate too much to them.
That's hard.
Had to keep it under wraps.
What is Joanne talking about? I see a little bit.
I finally finished a project that I still love and I am not in fear of.
Nice. Congratulations.
And she said, no one else will like it. Sorry for the typing goof.
Okay, so she's not. You're not afraid that no one else will like it?
She says you did that it because she liked it. Well, we need to see it so that we can tell you that we do like it.
From what I read, let's see. I still love and I am not fearing that no one will like it. Yes, that is being a brave creative, Joanne. Continuing like that through to the finish line. Yes, and please send us a picture in the group so we can see it.
Yeah.
I picked sticky thread, and that is the only way I can describe this. It's beautiful. It's got a little bit of a sheen to it. I think it's an ice yarn, but it does not want to slide off of my needle. I don't know why. Which is just, it's frustrating.
Well. Okay, Joanne has promised to post her picture.
Yes, thank you. I know, you know, it is scary still to post pictures. It really is. And I need to acknowledge that those of you that do share pictures, you know, you get the gold stars for being brave creatives because, you know, we're so happy when we get it done. And most of the time we really like what we've done. And there is that little underlying, the looking for our own Sally Field moment. Will they like it? Will they like it? Please, will they like it? I need a big needle. I need a different needle. How about this one? Okay, an 18. If nothing else works, I will just do some French knots with a big needle, right?
Gail says that she does not take, she says she takes lousy pictures.
I don't know. I bet she's a rough critic on herself, just like so many of us are.
Yep.
It gets easier. I mean, if you only have a camera phone, there's a lot of things you can do. Most important two things I would say would be, you know, to be steady and to have some good light.
Yes, good lighting is absolute.
You know, take it outside if you can. We're getting into the nice, you know, weather changes where we should have, you know, bright lights that we can go out and use Mother Nature's natural lighting, which is really going to help our photographs look better.
I think sometimes, just for those of you who are looking to improve your pictures, and I'm sure Barbie can back me up on this, you need to focus on what you're taking your picture of and make sure that there's nothing behind it that distracts from it. A lot of times, if you put a solid background or something behind your item, it makes it easier to see.
It's sort of like watching, if you're going to take a picture, you know, like if I'm going to take a picture of me right now, I wouldn't want to have something sticking up behind my head where it looks like this ruler is growing out of my head. It's the same way when you're taking pictures of your art. And I mean, how many of us have done family pictures like that? And you get back and you look at them and you've got like this, it looks like this plant is growing out of your head. And you think, oh, it'd be really nice to stand them in front of the plant. Really depends on the plant.
Or if you don't mind looking like a real carrot top.
Yes, exactly.
And the Boston fern coming out of your head.
Yeah. I'm excited to go take a drive. My husband and I like to go take drives and just kind of drive around and find some good backdrops for some additional photographs. Actually, I want to do some B-roll. I've been shooting some B-roll in the yard, but I want to get out and about some different places. It's also time for me to make my eye appointment so I can get some glasses.
Jory just joined us and she said, I guess I'm the only punk in the group who drove past my prom in a white tank and jeans and on the way to a slam at a punk show.
That's awesome. I love that about you, Jory. I love it. Okay, let's get rid of my loose threads. I've When I had basted a bunch of stuff on here, I never went back and cleaned up my threads. So I left these long, whoops, long threads. I don't know where this camera is. I never remember where the camera is on my phone. So then I end up doing this, you know, with my finger until I see where it focuses.
Barbie's got some hints for us. She said, simplify the background, get bright, natural light, turn off your filters, take a breath, hold it, and then shoot, and then exhale.
Nice. Yeah, the take a breath thing is something I always forget to do. And when I don't do it, it shows, because it really, it's funny. You think, is that really going to make a difference? It does.
Barbie said, Jory, I would have more fun with you than I did with my date. I wasn't a punk in high school, but I became one afterwards. I used to go to a place in Boston called Spit, S-P-I-T.
Oh, that's a great name for a hangout. Yep. I never was into the punk. I think maybe because skating was so much classical music and then the ranch was country music. So,
well, Jory, she says, don't worry. I look normal now. Messy bun and reading glasses. Yeah, I can't even get one leg into my leather miniskirt I used to wear.
I had one leather outfit. It was a long skirt with snaps up the front and a vest. Oh my gosh, I love that thing.
I used to wear, it was a leather mini skirt, and I'd wear boots or box. I had a favorite pair of boxing sneakers that I'd wear a lot. Mm. And with the leather skirt, my favorite thing was just an oversized, big, white linen t-shirt. It was like something, you know, doctors would wear or something.
I was never really super into clothes. Just wasn't my thing. Clothes and makeup.
Oh, it was the dancing that was the fun part.
Wow. No. Never, as an adult, never went out dancing anywhere. I guess I got danced out with skating for so many years.
Yeah, no, in my 20s, I went dancing a lot. I just, didn't really want to date. So I went to places where people were really kind of out of it.
Yeah, punk didn't exist when I was a teen either. I think, what was that, like the 80s or something that came in?
It wasn't when I was a teenager. It was like when I was in my 20s. 20s, some getting close to 30s. It was a club where everybody just, it was like Halloween every week.
Yeah.
You know?
I just couldn't do the music. It just didn't, it didn't connect with me, you know, but that's why there's so many different kinds of music, just like why there's so many different kinds of art. You know, we all connect on something different. And how wonderful it is that we have all these different opportunities, right? Oh, so a lot of people that were dancing in their 20s. What was I doing in my 20s? I was having babies in my 20s.
In my teens, I was playing sports.
Yeah. What was your sport of choice? What was your favorite thing?
I liked basketball.
I did too. I was too short to be any good at it, but I did enjoy basketball.
Oh, I was a ball handler. Mm. I wasn't one of the tall people.
Yeah.
My thing was pass it, steal it and pass it to somebody who can shoot.
I was a runner, even as short as I was, I ran hurdles, but I did a lot of, I was a good sprinter. That was my sport of choice when I wasn't at the rink. We had to take golf when I was in high school, and I thought that was the most boring semester of my life. It's like, oh, please let me go out and run track because this is so boring.
I actually liked golf. I was better at it than I thought I would be.
I hated it.
Yeah, basketball was more of a challenge. Margaret said that formals and proms didn't exist when she was a teenager.
Oh, wow.
So she never had a chance to have a long, gorgeous dress.
Wow.
Oh.
But did they have like coming out stuff? Because you were a teen in England, right, Margaret? So what was a big deal for a teenage girl back then? What was would have been a rite of
homecomings? And I don't know, my mom had proms, but she didn't graduate, but her yearbook had proms in them. You see, Wendy says, hubby and I went dancing before our kids were a twinkle in our eyes. I can remember one guy trying to impress the ladies in a tight red pair of denims.
Oh, my.
Oh, he must have been going for the Rod Stewart look.
And then there was the disco phase. I think my kids I was doing kid stuff by then, too. Well, either kids or ranch.
Disco and punk were about the same kind of time because people either went one way or the other
okay.
in the dancing crowd. Yeah, if you weren't disco, you were out punking.
And I was out shoveling stuff out of the horse stalls. So
Sue Brown says the only gorgeous dress I ever wore was her wedding dresses.
Oh.
And Gail says, oh, I guess I was in the mid-70s, started in Great Britain. So many have taken a while to get to the Midwest.
That's true. Yeah. The trends take a while to work their way across.
Margaret okay. says, however, when I got married, I didn't bother with it either. Not even white, not even a dress. A pink suit with navy blouse and hat.
Ooh.
And in the mid-60s, she was smashing.
Hats. I really want to investigate hats one of these days. I'm liking this yarn a lot more since I moved it up to a bigger needle.
Philippa says, oh, I think you're thinking of debutante balls.
Yes. Yeah,
absolutely.
You're right.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that was another whole thing for different people.
Yeah. Gail says, that's what I remember, disco. I was divorced already by then. Partied a lot. Yeah, I never did the disco thing because disco, you need to have a guy to dance with. So I liked the punk because you could just dance. Everyone danced. It didn't matter who you were or if anybody could figure out who you were.
Wow. Yeah, wasn't much into dancing. Didn't do parties.
Actually, I got into dancing because I broke my wrist roller skating.
Yeah, it was skating and horses for me. Skating and horses.
Barbie says, Margaret, that was really trailblazing to have a suit and a navy blouse.
All right, let's see if I can come up here. This makes the most beautiful, let me finish this one knot and then I'll show you guys. This yarn makes the most beautiful, shiny French knots. Not having this on a stand, I'm like, wait a minute. So let's see if you guys can see. I don't know if you can see how shiny they are, but it's just beautiful cluster of French knots. And that's with this, I don't remember the name on it, but I know it's an ice yarn. And they're nice. I like them.
I guess when the rest of us were dancing, Sandy was in marching formation in the United States Army, was for her at that time.
Wow. I never was drawn to the Army, but I did for a short time think I wanted to be a stewardess, which is just hysterical to me now because I don't like to travel at all. And yet I thought, oh, I could be a stewardess and I could travel over the world. And it was just really funny because it's just, no, not my thing at all. I probably would have hated it.
Oh, people are liking your project, Susan.
Thank you. Yeah, I think this yarn is really good for making the French knots. And then I think what I need to do on this one is, okay, can you see the organza here, the little gathers of organza? I think I'm going to do a whole lot more of those. And then a lot of these French knots. And then I'll do some of the traditional drizzles. But I think I'm going to do some of the detached bullions, which I've got the most recent video about that. And I'm going to do some cast on stitch that gets a different twist. Just trying to look for more ways that I can do vertical things that are interesting. Like, I love this stuff coming out of the center. Make sure I actually, and if I do it, let's see, this way. So this is just some rat tail thread and some silk thread of some kind. And so, yeah, just trying to find more ways that I can go up vertically, which there aren't a lot. I mean, I'm looking at old stitches, you know, medieval stitches to see if there's any, but of course, most of that stuff was surface embroidery. I'm looking at Brazilian embroidery. So now I'm thinking I need to kind of try and invent some things. Do I have a white collection going on too? Not a collection as such. This is the only white piece going on right now. But I do think after I finish these wildscapes, I'm going to do seascapes and I'll do a small collection of those and then we will hit colorscapes.
Jory says that she loves the white on white. She said a white garden of my dreams.
Oh, yes. White on white. And well, or when you shift it just a little bit and you go to that creamy neutral that we see in so many of the vintage neutrals or vintage journals, you get a completely different look from the white on white and the neutral on neutral. I don't know. They both evoke different things in me. So I do want to do colorscapes. I figure seascapes next because I have a lot of shells I want to experiment with. And I've figured out a lot of things I like and don't like on the wildscapes so that I can take that forward into the seascapes. And then colorscapes, which is going to take a while because I would like to get a variety in, you know, in various colors.
Okay. Gail says, I wanted to be a stewardess too, but never got tall enough for the requirements at the time.
Exactly. I think that's why I never pursued it because I never got any taller than I needed to be.
Barbie says that my friend didn't have a wedding with a big dress. She says for their 30th anniversary, she's going to throw a big party and we have to all dress up in thrift store wedding dresses.
Oh, how fun. That will be fun. Wait a minute. What is Wendy going to pull off? I missed that. Can you find that?
That's three more comments down.
Ah, sorry.
Okay, I'll get to it. Sue Brown says, what a cool idea. Margaret says, we didn't have a big gathering or ceremony either. Registry office wedding and only two required witnesses and then a party with a cake with pink icing. It should have been red for some reason, she says. Michelle says, Susan, do you up there's the white collection. Barbie says, I thought so, Sue. I am a very fluffy size, so I'm starting to look now. Wendy says, hubby and I want to renew our vows at home with our kids and fur babies. We've been married for 25 years and just want those that have stood by us all these years to be present.
Oh, how lovely.
Yeah. And Michelle says, seascapes sound very interesting. And Sandy says, Wendy, I'm afraid to do that after 45 years. What if Big Daddy says I don't? Instead of I do. You might have to script him. Sue Brown says, nice, Wendy. I hope you can pull it off. And Barbie says, LOL, Sandy. And Wendy says, Sandy, bribe him with food. And Sandy's getting a few LOLs there.
Sorry if that sound just came across there. My phone it was silent. I didn't know what it would do when I was live. So there was a vibration. That was what it was. It will be married 25 years this year, too, in October.
Well, John and I have been together going on 11.
Nice. Bribe him with food. Yeah.
Oh, Barb Clark just popped in and she says hello to everybody.
Hey, Barbara. I am on my phone, which is why there is only one camera going on right now, because our internet went down just literally as I hit the live button. It killed it.
Margaret says she's looking forward to the seascapes. Have you been thinking of, she's been thinking about one herself.
Yeah, it's interesting. I mean, because we live very close to the ocean. We're just like 10 minutes from the ocean. We don't go down there a lot, but it's there. But trying to think about how I will approach a seascape or rock pools more likely, but a seascape is different than a wildscape. You know, you don't necessarily have the rolling hills. There'll be lots of light colored French knots for sand, large expanse of water, perhaps that has nothing, and then piles of shells. I don't know. I'm definitely going to have to just kind of play around with them.
Gail says she's lost track of how many years she's been there.
That's kind of nice to have been together so long.
Absolutely.
One of my friends said she was going to be going away this weekend with her husband to celebrate, I think she said 56 years, which I just think is amazing. You know, especially in today's, you know, world. You don't hear as much about them.
Think of all the years of stress and everything that were spent unproductively. That if when you're in a long-term relationship, you have your ups and downs.
Yeah.
You know, just to know that all that time you've been able to count on somebody, you know.
Yeah. It's hard when you hear about other people celebrating long milestones. You think, oh, wow, you know, I could have had all this other time. But I have to remind myself how wonderful it is that I went through the journey I did to get to where I am. It made me who I am. And sometimes I forget that. Yep. You know, yep. It's very easy to look back and say, you know, why didn't I blah, blah, blah before then? Well, I wasn't ready. You know, I needed to grow. I needed to get to a certain point. Yeah, Barbie, I think the tide pools will be really fun, but I also am picturing maybe some of the seascapes will be very simplistic. I'm thinking about some different ways to do the water that I want to do with just a lot of French knots and colors. But then I want to do the rock pools. I want to do the coral reefs. So lots of research to make sure I have the images in my head. Yeah, all the blues. And Michelle, I don't know what it is, considering that green is my favorite color, but there must have been, when I was building my stash, there must have been a lot of blues in the thrift shops, because I have so many blues. I really need to do a lot of blues. That won't be a hardship, because they're beautiful colors.
Okay. Barbara says, we've only been married for 8 years, but we've been together for 30. It wasn't legal to get married until 8 years ago.
That's awesome, though.
Congratulations, Barbara.
Yeah, the underwater scapes, I love the idea of, but I guess that would have to be more surface embroidery, so I'll have to think about that, because I enjoy looking at surface embroidery. I have to decide whether it's something that really excites me. So you won't be able to tell probably how much progress I made, but I did make progress on this today. And thank you guys for rolling with me with the crazy internet stuff. And we made it work, right? We made it work. And that's what's so awesome about us gathering like this and getting to know one another. And if there's any lurkers here that haven't been here before, thanks for hanging with us. If you haven't done a thumbs up, please do. Tomorrow is the afternoon Zoom, so you can go over to my website and sign up for that if you want to join us. Let's see, any more announcements? I can't remember. I can't think. I'll go figure out what my husband has had to say.
Thanks for popping in, Hummer.
Hey, Hummer. I haven't seen you for a while. Hugs to you, dear. No, I try not to give up, Joanne. You know, I spent a lot of years giving up when I was younger. And boy, you know, there's no payoff in giving up. There is no payoff in giving up, but there is payoff in being brave and taking chances and putting ourselves out there. And when I think back about the beginning of my YouTube journey to now, I could not have gotten to where I am now without the support of all of you. And thank you as always, Terry, for being my sidekick and for reading chat for us. Go check out her Etsy shop and see the beautiful ephemera that she has for sale to make your job easier. And I'll see you guys next week, okay? Bye-bye for now.
Bye-bye.